Constitution of the Republic of Italy. The citizen's freedom of expression and the freedom of the press are the foundation of modern democratic societies. Over the years, my conviction that a democratic society, particularly a large-scale democratic society, cannot do without professional talent has increasingly been confirmed. The illusion of a total rejection of intermediaries in politics as well as in the field of information has shown and shows the limit of all millennial ideologies. The disappearance of the experienced mediators created a space for what we might call new mediators who elude collective verification and copy the manners but not the quality of their followers. In our field we have seen the phenomenon spread with an uncontrollable force. The very powerful new mediators of personal relationship and influence of the human race have rapidly become unavoidable hubs. I am of course referring to Google, Facebook, Apple and other hubs, which let us be saying immediately and clearly, I admire deeply for what they have made imagined, designed and produced, but in which I see both potential and risk. The risk due to the size of the OTT are caused for alarm for many reasons. The New York Times has underlined our Google's investment in artificial intelligence, in which the total social and economic future depends, are not balanced by anywhere near the level of investment by any government. Which is tantamount to say that it is not a view for in Cupertino, not in Washington or Beijing, that what we will be in 10 or 20 years is being designed. The big digital platform seem to have realized lately that professionally produced journalism is an essential condition for the survival of modern democracies. Turning to ourselves, we publishers have realized that declaring open war on Google and partners is fruitless, despite their use of our material without paying us. They have the means and resources to fight us off. So much so that we have moved from a situation of conflict between publisher and over the top to one of consultation, and in some cases, agreement based on the recognition of principles such as copyright. We ask to be allowed to do our job. The discussion may be very much wider. It cannot be just a question to settle with negotiation between the sides, with an enormous power difference to vote. If we are there, it is because we know long and believe we are going through a simple evolutionary phase, but we realize they are part of a real revolution in human relations and production. This revolution entails, for us, the discovery of a single fact: we are no longer edible. We are no longer the only ones collecting, processing, and providing information. We are no longer the only ones connecting people and institutions. We are no longer the only ones oiling the wheels of the economy and business with other data. The necessary to matter insufficient condition for affirming and building the news publishing world in a digitalized democratic society instead of accepting this evident truth. The publisher, journalist, and other professional figures who made our world great are today part of a much wider system. A veritable information ecosystem, to which belong association, non-profit organizations, commercial enterprises, and of other kinds, public and private institutions, individuals, and of course, the digital platforms, the infrastructure which enables but also limit freedom The question I put to myself and to you is as simple as it is disconcerting. How must the journal and news publishing change in a cultural system where the act of publishing is understood as simply question that enters me? The answer can only lie in the creation of a few models that are not interchangeable or applicable. Among the laws regulating the digital universe is the good enough law. Amid the clamor of content and services, the user often suffers from medium quality products sufficient for the context and need of the moment. Just look at the phenomenon of MP3 music files, whose quality is vastly inferior in other formats, but which are good enough on the bus, in the car, and in London of other listeners.
Limiting the use of data collected in one language.
to imagine data sharing, at least on some data. For example, I would add starting with data generated by the interaction of users with publisher content that is linked to, quoted from, or appropriated by the digital platforms. We already have available the data produced on our platform by user interaction with the content when published. The data produced on third-party platforms like Facebook are also produced from our content. I would want this to be recognized. In any case, data are the center of activity and distant interest of all the global players in the digital economy. So much so that a few weeks ago, the Italian Competition Authority, the Communication Authority, and the Italian Data Protection Authority announced a joint sector inquiry on big data to identify potential concern and define a regulatory framework to foster competition in the digital economy, to protect privacy and consumer, and to promote pluralism in the digital ecosystem. We will actively participate, since data have become the center of activity and interest for news professionals and journalists as well. These are mainly a few suggestions. I passionately know the of publishing profession, but it is evident that I and colleagues of my generation sometimes lack the cultural reference needed to tackle the problem it faces, which redefine our field much further than the traditional vertically integrated industry that the newspaper sector used to be. We must talk. Be open to the contribution of other cultures, professions, and competences. Let us do that. The moment has come to meet and talk about it. Let us begin in Italy by convening the Estate General of News Publishing, inviting all stakeholders and representatives of the various categories of the industry, leaders, publishers, journalists, painters, and opening to the others. Of course, over the top included. Italy should be just be the kickoff. I would love to see this blossom into a Europe-wide initiative. I repeat, we don't want state aid and we are not seeking subsidies. We want to find a way to remain profitable because if news publishing dies, as it is in the process of doing, it is not just an industrial sector that dies. It is an essential